Good afternoon all. Thank you for joining our today's webinar on discovering the new features in hidden features in RTM Designer. This session is on recording. We will be soon sharing the recording with all the attendees. If you have any questions during the presentation, during the demonstration, please type in the chat. Discuss at the end of our session. Now let us get started. The first hidden feature we are going to talk about the improvements in the length tuning. Whether you are working with multiple signal nets that required tuning across a number of signals, or you just need to length match two ends of a differential pair, or you will need to use some other for length tuning. RTM is in a dedicated time and effort on improving the existing tuning pattern while adding new patterns to its tuning capabilities. Length tuning now supports all three popular tuning patterns, trombone, sawtooth, and accordion. These new tuning patterns are rendered within a tuning sleeve, making it easy to slide the pattern along a root and around corners. All patterns can be applied to a single track as well as a differential pair. If you are working with low speed or lower frequency signals, you can get away with trombone tuning. You will notice that there are multiple 90 and 180 degrees turns in this stage perforation. Using cuts for these bends, preferable to use a hard right angle, in that it creates a smaller impedance discontinuity. There are a number of different movement and strike change behaviors available depending on where you click and hold on the sleeve. The sawtooth tuning uses a simpler polygonal area within which the pattern is built. Here we haven't used any smooth bends along the trace. These dimensions are used to minimize any impedance discontinuous along the length of the trace. There are great in place where building with an accordion is almost impossible due to the large number of objects near the trace or track. Accordion tuning and trombone tuning are similar in that they both use a Sepetian rooting pattern, but accordions help you to maintain tighter coupling along the length of the trace. Accordion tuning does not offset the Sepetian pattern off to the side of the trace. Instead, it can be rooted along the length of the desired signal trace, making accordions a better choice than trombone length matching for high speed differential pair signals. However, in some cases, there is not enough space to build an accordion. To combat the issues of limited space, RTM Designer 21 allows you to rotate the entire construction zone to better utilize space. These three tuning patterns help you to take advantage of specific types of geometries frequently used for high-speed designs. Using these tuning patterns allow you to fully utilize your layout space quickly and effectively. This is a new update we have in RTM 21. You will get a two tuning patterns. One is trombone and one more is sawtooth, and there is an improvement in the accordion. And the next hidden feature is generic components. It can be challenging to pick the right components when working on a new schematic, and many time is not necessary for early stage of development. To expedite the process of laying out the early stage of design, RTM has introduced the concept of standard basic generic components, which can quickly be placed in a design without the need to choose a specific manufacturer part from the available component source. Generic components are intended as placeholders that are easily replaced by a suitable component later in the design process. They also can be considered as a virtual or parametric components. Each type of generic component has a unique symbol for each identification and replacement. When you have a completed your prototype, you can replace individual components with the properties panel or a set of components of the same type with an active bond. And the one more hidden feature in RTM latest version is the new hotkeys for the 3D control. One of the hallmarks of RTM Designer is visualization and 3D tools. And as the time passing, we are adding more features to the enhanced 3D mode. One of the recent improvements in 3D mode is the appearance of rotation pattern in properties of models. In the properties panel, you are able to rotate the 3D model around the axis y and z axis, and the arrows on the numeric keypad correspond to 4, 6, and 8 are hot buttons for quickly rotating the models along the axis, thus providing the ability to quickly position any 3D body in the design plane. Also, a range of shortcut keys for manipulating the PCB 3D view is now available on the keyboard number pad. The new shortcut key provide a present level of rotation or panning in all directions, a set of predefined views, left, right, top, bottom, front, and back. And one more new feature in Alchemy is assigning multiple pins to multiple pads inside the Alchemy. And that means a component to the multiple pad of footprint. A flexible pin to pad mapping capabilities for managing components in single component data. This new pin panel allows component principles to be mapped to any component footprint pad. Using this data button, I can change a custom relationship in pin mapping with multiple footprint pads, which is a comma, will get numeric copy. This feature benefit assign multiple pins to a pad, a single pad, which is available in the latest version of Alten Designer. And one more new feature is test the embedded arrays, panelization of boards at any angle. In the Alten Designer 21, embedded board arrays can be placed at different angles within a PCB fabrication panel to improve fabrication as well as assembly process. And one more hidden feature is now we can able to see the proper area will be shown in the polygon board manager. This sheet is about the calculating polygons, that board area. When you have the polygon, it's really important to optimize the overall balance of your copper across any layer. Now you are able to see the precise area of your design. You are also able to generate a report of it. Once you have the report, you see the percentage of copper pour over the whole design itself. This helps manual calculation and save times, which can be applied on some of critical tasks. And one more feature is the component area calculation. On the top of it, it's also important to see the area of your component in relation to your overall board. This feature calculates and displays the total component area measurement and density percentage in the board information region of the properties panel in the board. To calculate density, double the board area and divide by component area. One more feature in Alchemy is the component contour selection. In earlier version of PC data, the bounding box of component was defined by a small rectangle that enclosed of all of the component primitives, copper, silk screen layer, objects, excluding silk screen test. This bounding box was used for selection and component collision checking, which made it difficult to select and collision check non-rectangle components, resulting in DRC, even though the components are not touching each other. A number of changes has been made in the piece to resolve this. The bounding box now rotates with the component when the component is rotated. If there is a shape defined on courtyard layer, the mechanical layer with the layer type is set to courtyard. That extract shape is used for selection and component collision detection. The restrictive nature of this approach was when the component was rotated, since the boundary box did not rotate, resulting in false component collision. With the help of the courtyard layer addition in the RTM latest version 20 and demo, if you draw a courtyard layer around the component, it will select that particular selection, which will avoid the DRC error if we are having a rounded components. And the next feature is testing alignment and justification. We had minor modifications for the years to test, but now you can do both alignment and justification for the testing. In earlier versions, the string location was left end of the string baseline, which changed the bottom left corner of the string boundary box. The boundary box was interactively enlarged. You can do horizontal shift to the baseline solution of the string, that is left, center, right over the string alignment, and it can be shifted to top, middle, and bottom This will get you perfect alignment of all strings and make it easier to create readable documentation. And one more feature is you can directly request viewer license. This is really a great improvement when you need just alternate visitor to view files. Previously, you have to update every 6 months. It was a whole process. You no longer have to do any of it. If you have alternate credentials, all you need to do is have an alternate account. You just sign it to your regular alternate designer installation, and it automatically recognizes that you are not using an active license. You can acquire an RDM viewer license. Let's say you not have an RDM live account already. You can talk to your admin of your company, of your organization. They will create a live account credentials for you, and then you can be able to sign in and get a viewer license for yourself. That means there is no need of visiting the RDM website for requesting for viewer. If you have RDM installation available, you request your live admin to create an account for you, and you can just sign in and you can get a viewer license within that tool itself. And the one more feature is creating a designated layers from the silk screen. Earlier, suppose if you don't have designated layer in the library, you don't get in the RDM. But the latest version from top silk screen, you can able to convert that sub silk screen to designated layers as per our requirement. When you want to make documentation easier, as we talked about, Altium has added ability to add designated layer for assembly drawings within your PCB. You can select that menu tools, add designator for assembly drawings. And it place is the geometry center of your components. You could able to also do in the PCB library. It will create apply to the all the component footprints. It is possible with the dot designator in Silk and in Draftman. You can select the Silk layer and the designator is automatically generated. And the next feature is, it is related to the smart PDF outputs. Throughout the years, Altium has been able to create device sheets, and you are able to create ports in hierarchy design and navigate through them while you are inside. However, many times reviewer wants similar functionality where easy navigation can be done on design outputs, that is PDF outputs. So now we can create a smart PDF. You are actually be able to click the sheet entries and the symbols and the ports to navigate to the design. If you click on the sheet entry, it will navigate to the its where it is connected in the latest release of Altium, where you can generate a smart PDF outputs in a smarter way. And the next feature is analog pads, removing of analog pads. Analog pads are pads on internal and external layers that are not connected to any active connective patterns of the layer. Technically, it creates a fieldless extra capacitance in certain designs which need to be removed. Removing non-functional pads can improve the drilling process, and it is essential. When you have an analog pad and vias in your design, previously you have to both remove the analog vias, and then later when you have needed to restore them, there was two separate items. So people are going back and forth. Now you are able to update both pads that are in use or remove and in use. In this, we have added a new scope which allow you to look at the both vias and the pads. Suppose you have, I want to remove the both analog pads and vias, you can able to remove it all together by selecting the option both. Is a new functionality has been added in the Altium Designer. And also now it is related to the view configuration panel. It is there since Altium 20. In Altium Designer latest version, now you're able to add separate layers. This will help you when you have, for example, a reference layer that you need constantly addressing. Let's say you are now on the top layer, you need to address a reference layer down in your design. You can make them permanent layer. Go down to the second layer more and make changes in your design while you're still able to see the layer. That means by holding control and selecting on the layer, it makes permanent. Whatever changes you do, it will affect the others, but that the permanent layer will be there all the time. These are new improvements in the latest version from Altium 20 and above. And there is something huge improvement, as well as Altium has working with CPU and over the last couple of years with simulation of impedance. And now you can do asymmetric strip line impedance calculations. The track is not in the middle of the two planes. And have also Altium has stacked two materials with different dielectric properties, and also choose in which direction the tray is going, either downwards as the picture top left, are upwards and other features you can see here. It's something that's unique to Alten Fasener, being able to, is being able to calculate within different diameter thickness, and it's something that you can could only do with Alten Fasener. And you could see that difference and both single and differential profile calculations in the latest developments of Alten Fasener. You can see we have got single differential pair and single coplanar and differential coplanar inside the RTM latest version. And the next feature we have is head assignment to the polygon core. When you have a copper core, for example, it could be a really difficult to assign it to it. Have hundreds of different nets. Going through all those nets to find the appropriate net can be extreme challenge. To make that really simple, you can click on this pipette button and next to you, go to the board, and you can see the little crosshair at the mouse pointer. You can see here, this is a pipette symbol. You can see it is kind of symbol. Just click on this symbol, and then you get a crossover. And, just take the and go to the RTM designer and select the net to assign the net to the polygon core. Automatically, it will add the net. There is no need of searching for the different nets. Okay, so from the properties panel, you can easily assign the net name to the polygon core. So the latest piece of RTM. And the next one is it is related to the alternate part. Alten Fasener schematic library editor offers the option to add an alternate symbol graphic to a component part to address various standards. When the part is specially designed, can be selected through the mode option in the graphic selection of the properties panel. You can see here, if you do a naming from here, you have to select which one you want to select. You want to select the normal one or an alternate one. That means RTM, we have a flexibility to add an alternate symbol to the component. While placing, you have to select which one you want. Now let us go through the demonstration of a few of these features which are hidden and which will be helpful in your design process. Let us have a look at the tool. Now I have a mini PC example. Now we are going to discuss about the new tuning patterns accordion, which is improvised. So we can access, we all know, in RTM we have got Activar over here. This Activar high commands used for the, you know, designing. PCB designing and schematic designing. Now, if you right click on this, you can see the commands available here. We have got a length tuning for a signal, and we have a length tuning for differential pair signal. Now, I need a length tuning for signal. Just select it. As soon as we select, you can be able to, you know, see the cross. I think it is selected. Yes, you can see the crosshair, which will. Which is the indication that this is selected. Then select the net which you want to do the tuning, and just draw your cursor and press tab. You can able to see, I think it is selected as a trombone. Let me first start with the accordion to trombone and followed by sawtooth. So let's see, we just try to select the different tuning pattern. I think, yes. Press by tuning, after selection of tuning, if you press tab, you can be able to select the different patterns. I just need an accordion, and here you can able to select the amplitude and the space and what is the meter per space and style. You can able to select from here. I just select emitted lines and then resume, and then here you can able to see if you enter tab, it will pause the tuning, and you can able to select the pattern you want. If you want meter args, select it and enter. You can see here it is selected. Or if you want to change the meters, just press space bar. You have to change between the three different selections. And if you want to increase decrease the amplitude, just press three. Sorry, time. You just press the 3 and 4 to increase or decrease the time. If you want to increase the amplitude, decrease the amplitude less than and greater than to do so. And if you want to adjust the corners, this percentage, the corners percentage, you have to use 1 and 2 shortcut keys to do so. And also, you can also do by using the mouse. By using the mouse, Just select the pattern and you can able to select it here. You can able to increase, decrease, and also you can able to move this one to the your desired location. It will automatically adjust the tuning pattern as per the space availability. And also if you want to rotate this tuning, just hold control and you can able to rotate this tuning pattern as per our requirement. Okay, this is how you can able to do the accordion tuning. These are the improvements has been done to the accordion tuning. Now let us see about the different the two tuning patterns which are implemented. Just start the tuning pattern and press tab, hit tab below the properties panel and select the thumb mode tuning, and you can see what is the space we need. You can select here and you can see the what is style you need. You can able to select from here the same styles we have. You can see here now it's at top. Now if you want to shift to the bottom, you can able to select rounded, and you can just select single ended. Now you can see rounded. Okay, now if you want to change it, press hit tab, you can able to change. Okay, and also you can able to by selecting this, you can able to also increase or decrease the size of the pattern, like in the accordion. Okay, and the next one, last one we have is sawtooth, which is like normal tuning. You can able to see the what is the angle you need and what is the it's single ended or a flexible side. You can able to select, you can able to do the tuning. Okay, like single to do the tuning for a single end signal. Like single end signal, you can also do the line tuning for the differential pair. Hit tab, just do the accordion tuning, and you can select the net. And you can able to do the tuning. I think we have selected the single end signal. You have to do the differential pair. Okay. Differential pair. Okay, see here. Okay, you can press space bar, we'll get the different styles of patterns. Okay, like this, we're going to do the trombone as well for the differential pair where if we have a space constraint. Okay. They are the new patterns and implements implemented for the in hope you able to understand this video. Okay, anyone having any questions, please type in the chat. Yes, now we're going to talk about the generic components. Generic components is like when you are doing a prototype design or when you are in the initial phase of your product, there is no need of picking the right component. You can just simply pick a generic components. Altium in the latest days has implemented this feature where what and all components are mostly used in the design, they are added as generic components. Just pick those components and you can place them directly in the schematic sheet without selecting for right schematic symbol. And then later, when your prototype is done and you are going for the master design, then you can able to update to the your required component. Now see, I have got four registers over here. Now I just select it and I just added them. Yes, now I added the all the component. The annotation has been done. Designators are added. Now we want to add a value to the component. We want to add this one as 1 kilo ohm. That is the value I want to have for this component. And then once my prototype is done and I'm going for the master design, I can directly select these all these components and I just go to properties panel. I just assign a proper I can pick a proper component from the my library. Okay, or else by using the active bar, I could able to assign a proper component to this generic components. Now I just use the active bar. By using this active bar is like a tablet representation of your component using your design. It will help you to verify all the components having proper good like pricing information, stock availability is there or not, whether the component having proper life cycle is there or not, or you can verify all the component status at a single place. Now if you look at our generic components, R31, yes, here are the components. Here now I want to assign a proper component from my library for my master design. For that, what I will do, I just right click here, operations, change the register of 1 kilo ohm. Then what will happen, the tool open the components panel. For the component panel, I can have to change the required component from here. I can choose the what is it component category, and I can directly search for the component of value 1 kilo ohm. See, I got 1 kilo ohm multiple results. I can control plus select. I can able to do the comparison as well inside the RTM. Which one will suit your requirement? I can able to judge decide. The text with the red denotes the difference. See, this component, particular component having larger width inside, it is 805 package, this is 042 package. If you have lesser width, I can just use this point. You can see the power and the other information as well. Just select it, the one which you require. Okay, and just click OK. Then automatically, that particular component data will be added to here. This is good changes. Okay, and close it. Now see, now it is pushing the data from the server. You can see component has been added with the all the supply and life cycle. Okay, assign your master data. Okay. Now let us talk about the new feature in Altium Visioner is 3D shortcuts. This is one of the unique feature in Altium where we have got very good 3D rendering. Now Altium has implemented the 3D shortcut keys where you can able to use from the number keypad, where you can effectively rotate your board in 3D with help of the new releases. The new release by pressing 3, you can able to see here. Visually, you used to hold Shift plus right mouse click to rotate the component. Instead of that, you can able to use your numeric keypad to rotate. The same keypads can available here, view 3D control. There are shortcut keys. Suppose when you press a number key C on the keyboard, it will rotate right, or when you press a control plus number 4, it will rotate right. Okay. Based on the shortcuts, you can able to see if you want to isometric view, you can able to see what is the left edge, just press 3 keyboard, you can see the left of the board, what the internal also you can able to visualize. Okay, there are 3 shortcut keys you can able to access from here, view 3D controls. If you have a numeric keyboard, number keyboard on your computer, on your computing keyboard, shortcut keys to rotate your in 3D. Okay, this is the one feature added in the 3D view for the RTM. Okay, in the next feature, we are going to talk about pads mapping. Again, I will open this schematic sheet. Let me delete this one. We'll just place one component, my name CAD 54. It's a 2-pin component, and the footprint will be having the 3 pins. Yes, you can see having a footprint with 3 pin keypads as well as 20 package. But symbol is having 2 pins. We'll just see how we can map the pins in the symbol editor. You can see this is a component we have got multiple pins and assigned to the pin 2 and 3 are assigned to the pin 2 in the footprint. Now let us see how it can be mapped inside the component editor. Right click, edit. When you open the component editor from the components panel, you're able to assign a multiple different footprint to the different selection. To click on this single pin editor, you can see here we have assigned anode pin 1 to the footprint SOTN and 2 and 3 to the medium. Okay, and in normal, we have assigned for the third pin, second and three, and for the first pin, we have only assigned single pin. Okay, in the this footprint, that means second pin, we have assigned third pin here, and first pin. Okay, but here we have added here 2 and 3 in this one. Okay, like this, you can have to assign the multiple pins to the pads by separation of comma. Okay, that means in this footprint 1, 1. For the one pin, we have assigned the pin pairs of 2 and 3. But here in the third pin, we have assigned 2 and 3 and one pin here. Okay. If you look at here, if you select the first pin, you can see only first pin are selected. Okay. Here, if you select three here, see it's only selected first pin. That means this pin is assigned to here in this footprint. In this footprint, this one is assigned to 2 and 3. Okay, but here we have only one pad. Okay, like this, you can see. Let me start with assigned to 3 and 4 here in this footprint. If you look at the this one here, and go to properties, you can see the footprint here assigned is normal. Okay, and I can change this one to medium. Now you can see here, second and third pins are assigned to anode and first pin is assigned to cathode. Okay, like this, I can able to assign the pads and footprints alignment. Okay, from the drop down. Okay, like this, you can able to add multiple pins to the multiple pads inside the alternator. Next, we are going to discuss about the polygon core area calculation. Okay, let me open. Just a second. Just give me a second. I need to open. Just give me a second. I'm just opening a right example list, I think. Yes, give me a second. In the meantime, if anyone has any question in the chat, please do type in the chat. We just discuss the queries. I'm just opening the, I think the example file where I removed the polygon. That's why I just opening a fresh file from my examples. Sorry for the inconvenience. This file is taking a bit time. I think we are almost done. In the meantime, please do type your question in the chat. We shall discuss. Yes. Now, as I told, with the latest release of RTM, we've been able to see the, you know, your total polygon area. If you go to properties panel, when nothing is selected, you can able to see the density of the board, how much density the component area, and what's the component area occupied in the board. You to see and density of the board also you can able to see here, and also you can able to see the polygon board area. What is the how much area the polygon is covered? Earlier versions you have to, you know, calculate manually, but in the latest release, it's been implemented. You can see this particular area, copper on the top, this much square amount it's been occupied. See this one, this much and also been able to generate all this as a report. We'll get the percentage of each polygon pore as a report. Okay, from here you can able to see how much area they have covered, and also by this properties panel, if you go to reports, just select the copper area and then click report. Then we'll get a HTML report which will guide and how much the area of the polygon is covered in your design. The HTML report will be generated. Okay. This is a new feature which will help us to calculate and know how much area the polygon is covered in the design. You can properly get the polygon for others as well based on this particular report. It is taking use time. There is one query. Let us read out in the meantime. Let it load. I think a query from Mahesh. Do you need to add the symbol which used in the schematic capture again to project library from component common library? Do we need to add the symbol which used in the schematic capture again to the... I think Mahesh, your question is confusing. I'm not sure. Maybe I think when you are capturing a symbol, I don't know, your question is confusing, Mahesh. Maybe you can email me your query, this name or email I just discuss. Is my number, you can call me or WhatsApp me, we can discuss. But this question is confusing me. Okay, you can see the report, how much square amendment, what is the percentage officially recommended to see as a detailed inside the RTM latest version. Okay. And the one more feature we have is the viewer license request. You got license management. If you have valid RTM live credentials with you, you can just put license management, and you can directly click on get viewer license. If you click on get viewer license, we'll be able to get a viewer license directly from RTM design. And within the RTM design, there is no need of this RTM website. I think there are the features which are hidden inside the RTM